Events in the largest film franchise of all time, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, have been building to one showdown. The Avengers versus Thanos, a mad purple titan who's seeking to wield the Infinity Stones. These stones apparently contain vast cosmic power, but why? What's inside them that could defeat a team of superheroes? Douchebag of the Week asks, what happens if an Infinity Stone shatters? Well, douchebag, it's his name. That entirely depends on what's inside the Infinity Stones. The comic books have a lot of different answers for that, so let's stick with what's inside the gems or stones in the MCU specifically. Since Iron Man in 2008, we've seen 5 out of the 6 Infinity Stones that Thanos needs. Inside the Tesseract, inside the Orb from Guardians of the Galaxy, inside the parasitic Aether from Thor: The Dark World, inside Loki's Scepter, now inside the Vision's head, and inside Doctor Strange's Eye of Agamotto. Now, according to Guardians of the Galaxy's The Collector, the Infinity Stones are really singularities, regions of space-time where physics seemingly breaks down that existed before the universe did. These singularities were then forged into ingots which give their owners immense cosmic power. Ah, beautiful. So it stands to reason that if you were holding an Infinity Stone, you would be holding a spherical hole in space-time with infinity at its center, all in the palm of your hand. It seems far-fetched even for a superhero movie. But it's not impossible to hold a singularity in your hand if what you're really holding is a black hole. This is the Earth. It has a mass of around 6 trillion trillion kilograms and a radius of a little over 6,000 kilometers. Because of its mass and size, objects hoping to escape its gravitational pull must be traveling at least 11 kilometers per second. But if you give Earth more surface gravity by squeezing all of its mass down into this exact radius, then it hits its Schwarzschild radius, named after physicist Carl Schwarzschild, or where the escape velocity of an object is greater than the speed of light. This defines a black hole, a three-dimensional hole in space-time that nothing, not even light, can escape. To squeeze an object down to its Schwarzschild radius, its internal pressure must be overcome by gravity, sort of like when a dying star's internal temperature can no longer push outwards against the gravity of its own mass. When that happens, there's a gravitational collapse into a singular point with no coordinates in this universe. Think about that for a second. It's a gravitational singularity, a point in space where gravity is so strong that the equations that we know in physics start popping out infinity as the answer. Black holes inside the Infinity Stones would explain their singularities, so now we have to figure out if one could fit in your hand and whether or not we could get energy from it. Oh. We tend to think of black holes as giant galaxy eaters. We have one at the center of our Milky Way galaxy, but they don't have to be that big, at least not mathematically. If I took just 10 times the Earth's mass, not a lot in cosmic terms, and shrunk it down to this exact size, it would become a black hole with a singularity inside. But more importantly, this black hole would be emitting a lot of energy. Do you know why Stephen Hawking is famous? It's because he theorized that black holes can die. In 1974, Stephen Hawking, along with some other scientists, calculated that a black hole should emit radiation in proportion to its mass, its surface gravity, and its area. They imagined this by thinking about the event horizon of a black hole, the point of no return. According to quantum mechanics, particle-antiparticle pairs can pop right on this boundary, but only one will fall into nothingness, and the other will escape. Because of this exchange, a black hole must be losing energy and therefore mass. This points to a finite lifespan for all black holes. Black holes can just evaporate. This Hawking radiation is proportional to a black hole's mass, so as it evaporates and gets less and less massive, it's emitting more and more radiation in the form of gamma rays and light and other particles. When a black hole eventually evaporates down to the size where it could fit inside an infinity stone, or better yet, down to subatomic size, it's converting enormous mass into enormous energy. In 1974, Dr. Hawking also calculated that at the very end of a black hole's life, it is erupting with the same kind of energy that the meteor that killed the dinosaurs had. All in a tenth of a second. Miniature black holes really could be the source of the Infinity Stone's power. So what's really inside the Infinity Stones? Tiny black holes. Not only would they fit inside the stones themselves, they have singularities inside them, just like the collector says, and when unleashed, if they were at the end of their lives, they would emit the kind of energy that would vaporize enemies. Not only that, but scientists now believe that during the formation of the universe, these kind of miniature black holes could have existed. I think we got it all to check out. So call me, Marvel, because science. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to follow me on Twitter at SciFile to suggest ideas for future episodes, and on Instagram under the same handle where I'm posting mini episodes of Because Science. I'm hosting the new Mythbusters show as well, so check that out Saturdays on Science Channel. I think we did a pretty good job. I know that you may be skeptical being Mythbusters fans. I'm a fan too, but we did some pretty damn cool stuff that it involves exploding water heaters. And a very special thanks to Marvel Puzzle Quest for sponsoring today's episode. If you like Marvel and Match 3 games, check out Marvel Puzzle Quest, available now on Apple and Android devices. Recruit your favorite Marvel heroes and villains to battle your friends and compete in tournaments. The latest update features Riri Williams, aka Ironheart, the genius teenager who reverse engineers Iron Man's suit. Thanks, Marvel Puzzle Quest. For most of my life, I thought that black holes were literally black holes, just holes in the fabric of space-time, and I think I blame that on most popular science conceptions. They always show you that it's like a hole in the ground that Wile E. Coyote could fall into, but it's not. A black hole is a hole in every direction, which is a sphere. If you look at a sphere from any angle, it looks like a flat circle. So black holes are spherical holes, and when you get near them, every direction is down. Any direction that you look at a black hole from is down, because that's where it's trying to pull you, and because you can't escape from a black hole, it would be your last down, your last direction.